Before we move ahead for more decision making policies, we just need to make sure of one particular point that so far from the learning perspective, we have taken only two or three different classification points, right? So sometimes we have two features, sometimes we have three features, and we have only three or four classes as well. But in practice, in most of the cases where most of the systems that we have to build, let's say for Amazon, Netflix, all of these companies, we don't actually have these low numbers of features. We have much more number of features and much more number of classes. Okay. So for that particular thing, we actually need to remember that we have huge dimension in the data for classification. Okay. So it's a bit hard to have discriminative information or to discriminate these information based on the conventional measure of distance. Okay. So far I have said that, okay, yeah, this and this point, this one is similar, closer to this compared to this based on the simple Euler's distance equation, x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square and so on. But sometimes when you have like 20 of those features, it's not possible to do that simply. Okay. So higher dimension is not, when you have huge number of features, nearest and the farthest points are almost same. Okay. And it's something that you may not feel that way, but it comes to be true because for you, there are features x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, but in the distance formula, it's still one pair, two pair, three pair, four pair. So it will not be able to actually wait out the things. It will measure simple distances, and that is why the points are not measuring the distance between the points in higher dimension is not an ideal solution. Okay. So we'll actually not be able to use nearest neighbors and all these when we have very huge number of dimensions. Definitely we can use them for smaller ones, and even in the bigger one we will have to modify and use them for some small parts of it, but entirely will not be able to rely on the nearest neighbor. So when you have high dimensional requirements, you'll not be able to depend on nearest neighbor and any such classification which has the basic conventional distance measure. Okay. Similarly with the decision tree, the problem lies in the height of the tree. Let's say I have 50 different features, okay? Or let's say I have 50 different classes. Then even to differentiate between, let's say at each level, it is able to differentiate between two different classes. It will have 50 different levels, okay? And that is the ideal case scenario. But if we have 50 features for 50 different classes, or let's say even 20 different classes, we may have a decision tree which is way too precise, okay? And we have not discussed it yet, but there are a lot of concepts like being something way too accurate for the training data set. I mean, I'm really good at training data set, but I'll be extremely bad in the tests. And that is because you start memorizing each and every detail of the problem instead of learning the pattern or the basic logic behind the pattern. So if we give way too much to learn, the machine will start memorizing, because that's the simplest solution to give answers. Okay. So we don't want that as well. Okay. So that particular thing has to be skipped as well. So for huge dimensions, even decision tree is not a very good solution, because the tree structure will be way too difficult to create. And we will see actually that it's the complexity of each of these algorithms, how difficult it is to make each of these algorithms after a while. So you'll be able to understand why are we preventing decision tree from a very huge classification, okay? But then which classifiers can we use? As I said, linear SVM, as we discussed, for multiple classes, we don't actually need multiple SVM. We can do it like this, okay? So this sort of a SVM can be used. Multiple linear SVMs can come together and do it for multiple classes. And since it will change from lines to hyperplanes, okay, hyperplanes is nothing but normal planes, but multiple dimensions. Okay, you'll not be able to picture it out, but hyperplanes is planes only with 4, 5, 6, 8 dimensions. So hyperplanes will be able to differentiate between the classes. So the logic will still remain the same, but instead of x1, x2, it'll be x1, x2, x3, x2 till xn. Okay. Similarly, there's something called as naive bias, and that is based on the Bayesian theorem. If you have studied probability. Okay, so Bayesian theorem is conditional probability. I will be able to predict the probability of something knowing the already happened cases. Okay, so the already happened cases will be our training set, and I'll be able to predict the classes of the new items. Okay, so those sort of learning algorithms, again, logistic regression based classification, what this is, you don't need to remember, but you just need to know that there are classifiers, which can help you when the dimension go extremely huge. But at this point, you should just know that, okay, if somebody asks you that, okay, can I use nearest neighbor? Can I use decision tree for, let's say, 30 features or 60 classes? You should say no. Okay, straightforward no would be good enough. If they ask why, you can explain what are the key problems with these sort of algorithms when we have higher dimensions.